Hey guys, my name is Nikki Whiting and I am a Beachbody coach. And today I just wanted to basically share with you my why and my reason for why I became a Beachbody coach and why it continues to inspire me every day. I have made a video similar in the past, but I think that what we realize over time is that our goals and our reasons behind why we do things start to change, and I think that that's a good thing, that they're always ever changing. So I just wanted to share a little bit about my story and how I came to be a Beachbody coach, what the background is there, and you know, what it's done for my family and for myself personally over the last 17 months. So with that said, I have a 2-year-old daughter and she's my life, obviously. But when I was about 5 months postpartum, I felt just not like myself. I felt like my body was completely different. And I think that any moms can relate to that feeling where, you know, you put yourself on the back burner for so long and you do everything for your kids. And then you get to this place where you're like, okay, well, I still want to be a great mom, but I also feel like I'm deserving of having a little bit of me time. And I think that's where a lot of parents and moms struggle, is they almost feel guilty. And that's kind of how I felt. And so about 5 months after our daughter, I had a friend, Stephanie Chico, who asked me to be in one of her challenge groups. And she basically gave me an open invitation on Facebook and asked if I wanted to do a Beachbody program and be in the small support group for other women who were doing the same thing. And so I told her, I said, I already have some Beachbody programs. Are you okay with me doing ones I already have? She opened, you know, the doors and said, of course, like, come join us. I don't care. I just want you to have some support. And that was huge for me because I still really didn't know what these groups were about and if it would work for me. So I started with Brazil Butt Lift. And I think the first month, I think it was a 6-week program, and I lost about 7 pounds. And honestly, at about 5 months, I didn't really have that much weight to lose. It was just like the change in my body was just the way it looked, and the inches, I think, was where I really wanted to lose some weight or see some difference. And so I was super excited after that first month getting those great results. And then she asked if we wanted to all do Insanity. And we actually had Insanity, but I had never done it, like, from start to finish. And this is kind of what those groups allowed me to see, was the importance of actually starting a program. And from day one, doing it all the way through the end and following the calendar, as it said, and starting to eat better. So I learned a lot about clean eating and just better food choices. And through all that, I learned a lot about Shakeology, although I never had bought, you know, a month's supply. And then loved what Insanity did. I loved the results I was getting. And she approached me and said, you know, you're already posting about what you're doing and you're sharing it with everyone. Why don't you become a coach just like me? And I kind of like laughed it off and said, you know, thank you so much for thinking of me, but I don't feel like this is something that I can do or that I'm cut out for. And I think the idea of the word coach kind of made me nervous. You know, I didn't necessarily feel qualified. I still was on my own journey. And she encouraged me that a lot of people actually like to be on a journey with their coach, feel like they have that connection and can actually relate when you're still going through your transformation. And I just said, no, I'm just going to continue to do the groups, but thank you. And she asked me 2 more times, and by the 3rd time, I said, all right, well, let me talk to my husband because I would at least like to have the discount. And at that point, I was seriously considering Shakeology and thought, well, I could get, you know, 25% off the products. So talked to him, and at first he was skeptical. He was one of the biggest skeptics, and he said, well, I feel like maybe this is just going to be a waste of money. We're going to throw money into a business. You're not going to make anything out. And I was super nervous too. My biggest fears were, one, that I would never grow team, and two, that I would just, my fear of failure was completely scary to me. I'm an anxious person already, so that kind of overwhelmed me. But he said, you know what do you have to lose? And that was the truth. We really didn't have anything to lose. I wanted to be on the products. I loved the company. I knew that I could get results, and other people could too if they just followed this. And so we decided that I would do it. I was staying at home. I had that feeling of, you know, I knew I was doing a lot as a mom, but I wanted that feeling of contributing financially and that sort of thing. So did it, started. We did not have a training. We didn't have anything like that. We did have great tools in a coach group, and that was super helpful. And, you know, now we have these amazing trainings that all of our leaders have put together for us, and it's just kind of laid out there for us, which is great. And so I just started asking others if they wanted to do the same thing. And, you know, my reason at the time was just to feel like me again, to kind of get myself back after the baby, to have, you know, that adult interaction, because I miss that. I was around our daughter all the time, and I just wanted to be able to, you know, connect with other adults, and then obviously to provide financially. And so the first step was when I was able to pay for groceries on my own. That was, you know, big for me. And eventually I was able to pay some of our bills. And, you know, now what had originally turned out to be this discount thing has turned into a full-time business from home, making six figures and doing something that I absolutely love, all while I'm able to be with our daughter and make my own hours. So that was huge. And it's very heartwarming when you see challengers starting the way you started and seeing them make those changes and start to get those results and those progress pictures start popping up. And it's just incredible to watch others do what made you so happy, you know, in the beginning. And that's kind of how my video changes now, is my why has sort of changed. You know, now I really get excited to watch my coaches start this life change. You know, it's a full circle thing when you can watch your challengers create success for themselves and see a change and just gain confidence. But it's also another thing when you've grown a team and now those leaders are stepping up. They're helping others get results. They are becoming independent and more confident and replacing their income and, you know, having them resign from their job so that they can do this full time and be with their family the way that I was with Wesley. And it's just all really amazing to watch happen. I feel like this company is special, and there is a lot that goes into making the coaches feel special and wanted and needed. And you know, I was a very anxiety-ridden person. I still struggle with that, and I was on medication for a long time, and it's just very paralyzing almost, and it's hard to see past the next day when you feel that way. And I realized that the previous jobs that I was going to every day were causing that a lot of times. It was making me feel like this horrible feeling of, this is not what I want to be doing, and I can't be successful doing this, and I don't know. So it got to the point, I was an elementary teacher before this, and it got to the point with one of my jobs that I dreaded it so much that my husband had to actually drive me to my job in front of the school. He would park and say, you can do this. It was like a pep talk. You know, get out of the car. You're going to be okay. Just go in there and make the best of the day. I mean, it was just every day, and it was so exhausting for me. I wasn't eating. I wasn't working out. I was malnutritioned and sad And it was affecting everyone around me. It was affecting my parents. It was affecting my husband. I mean, who wants to put their husband through that every day? And it just got to the point where he said, enough's enough. Like, this is going to make us both miserable. And, you know, to find a job that I absolutely love. Like, I love to get up and work early before anyone's awake. I love to set goals. And I don't know, it's just a different feeling when you actually find something that you're super passionate about doing and that can provide for your family as a full-time income. And so I just hope that you guys find, you know, your passion and what drives you and what moves you and your why behind what you're doing. I think that there are so many things that can fulfill us in life, but you want to love your job and to be able to say that I do and that I work with an amazing group of people is great. And I hope that all of you who have ever, you know, thought about following your dream or your passion, that you go for it and don't look back, because there's really nothing to lose. Have a good day, guys. Bye.